Should you update to iOS 15.2? And what's new in iOS 15.2? Well, in this video, I'm gonna answer both of these questions because these are my picks for the top iOS 15.2 features. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custodian. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. And iOS 15.2 has officially been released. So today I'm gonna cover whether or not you should upgrade to iOS 15.2, and I'm gonna share the top iOS 15.2 features. We have a lot to cover, so are you ready? Then let's go. So first, if you're new to iOS 15 in general, you may want to click up here and watch my video on all the best iOS 15 features first. And second, you know my rule by now. Before updating any OS, always back up and sync your device. But with that said, let's start with what's new in iOS 15.2. First, a whole whack of bug fixes, which is why installing these supplemental updates is so important. So, not to bury the lead here, but should you update to iOS 15.2? Yes, yes you should, in order to access these important bug fixes. There's now a fix for Siri not responding when VoiceOver was running and the iPhone was locked. ProRAW photos had some overexposure issues, and that has been addressed as well. There were also bug fixes for HomeKit and CarPlay, plus iPhone 13 models had experienced some issues with video streaming apps, and that's been fixed in iOS 15.2 as well. And there's been a fix to calendar events appearing on the wrong day for Microsoft Exchange users. So now that you know why you should update to iOS 15.2, let's move on to the number two top feature of iOS 15.2, and that's the all new app privacy report. Ooh, this one is a good one indeed. So to access the app privacy report, you're just gonna head to your settings and then select privacy and then tap on app privacy report. Then just turn on app privacy report. So with the app privacy report, you're gonna get a snapshot of individual app data and sensor access, as well as app network activity. By default, the app privacy report is gonna show you the past 7 days of data and sensor access, app and website network activity, and the most frequently contacted domains. It's really handy. All right, the next thing that's new in iOS 15.2 is the new music app search functionality. More specifically, you can now search directly within a playlist without having to go into the search page. So from the music app, just open up the playlist you want and then swipe down. So similar to how you would do like in the Mail or Notes app, and now a search bar appears at the top. So when you search using this search bar, you're now gonna get results just from this specific playlist. And speaking of music, Apple has now added a new subscription plan called the Apple Music Voice Plan. Yes, that's right, a voice plan. So Siri users, this is for you. The new Apple Music Voice Plan is $4.99 US per month, and it allows you to listen to any song in Apple Music without ads, if you use Siri to make the request. So this is really just for users who want to use their voices to activate their music rather than going into the music app. Now, you won't have the spatial audio feature with this, nor will you have lyrics, but you can ask Siri to play new music based on your interests and use the pause and control buttons within the app as well. At $4.99, it's half the price of the cost of an individual plan, so this could be more for you if you don't want to spend the $10 a month on Apple Music. Now let's move on to another neat feature of iOS 15.2. You'll now be able to review the parts and service history of your device. That's right, you're gonna be able to check whether or not your device was repaired with a genuine Apple part. Pretty neat. So all you have to do is head to your settings, then in general, tap on About. If your iPhone or iPad has had a part replaced, like say the camera as an example, it's gonna show up in this section now. So if the replacement camera is genuine, it's gonna be labeled as a genuine Apple part. But if it's a third-party part, there's going to be an alert icon and an unknown part label there instead. How neat is that? And if you're enjoying this video so far, I'd love for you to give it a like and remember to subscribe to my channel for more content like this. I'd really appreciate it. And now back to our list. The next iOS 15.2 feature is a much needed update to Find My. That's right, you can now find your iPhone even if the battery is dead. Yes, really. Okay, so what's gonna happen is that if your iPhone runs out of battery, Apple's gonna put it into a state that they call power reserve mode. Now, during this state, your iPhone can be found using Find My. But here's the little caveat to this. You're only gonna have about 5 hours in this power reserve state. So up to 5 hours after your iPhone dies, you'll be able to find it using Find My. So this is still very helpful. And speaking of dead, you can now create a legacy contact in iOS 15.2. All right, a bit of a morbid transition there, but we aren't gonna be here forever, okay? But our devices, yeah, they will be here forever. So it's important to set a legacy contact in order to access your information after you're gone. Just like you can on Facebook, you can now set a legacy contact for your iPhone or iPad. So first, to set a legacy contact, from your settings app, head on over to your profile, then select password and security, and then here just tap on legacy contact. Now here you're gonna follow the prompts to set up a contact that will be able to access and download your Apple ID data should you pass away. Now Apple's gonna provide a special code for this, and I believe that you're gonna have to have a death certificate as well. Then Apple will unlock the iPhone or iPad. And by the way, if a friend or family member has already added you as a legacy contact on their end, they're going to appear here too. All right, on to slightly less upsetting thoughts. Apple has added communication safety options to iOS 15.2. So if you're a parent of a minor, just a heads up, you're gonna have to opt into this. So here's how it works. Once enabled, the Messages app will scan incoming messages on your children's devices for nudity or unsafe content. Now, what will happen is that a message will appear telling your child that the photo could be sensitive and asking if they want to review it. Then they're going to be able to either view, not view, or in fact message a grown-up about the potentially upsetting photo or video. Now, Spotlight Search has also been updated with this same feature. Now this is just a quick list of the top iOS 15.2 features, which by the way, if you're on iPhone 13, there's even more features in iOS 15.2 for you. Like as an example, there is a change to the macro mode in the camera app. And there are other cool updates like iCloud Plus and new SOS emergency alert features, but we'd be here all day if we went over every single new feature of iOS 15.2. So listen, if you've made it to this point in the video, I want you to drop a comment below like, I heart iOS 15.2 or iOS equals heart emoji. I would love to connect with you. So will you be updating to iOS 15.2? What do you think of my favorite top iOS 15.2 features? What are your favorite features? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more iOS content. Thanks for watching. See you next time.